Good morning, boys and girls. No, no, no. That's not how we do it here at Pepper School. Let's try this again. Good morning, boys and girls. All right, boys and girls, I am on tiptoe expectation. I am excited about the program that we have planned for you today. Boys and girls, this is our annual Lyrics and Literacy event. It is a celebration of Black history. You guys have been working hard over the past few weeks, learning all about the history of the United States. Well, actually, it's worldwide. Black history is not limited to the United States. It is the history of the world, and you guys have learned so much, and we have this program today as a culminating event. I would like to thank the parents for coming. I would like to thank the teachers for your patience. And boys and girls, Mrs. DeLu has shared with you the behavioral expectations. So we're going to have a great time, and I am going to turn this program over to none other than Mrs. DeLu. Let's give her a round of applause.
Good morning, boys and girls. Just like Mr. Haley said, Black History Month is not something we just celebrate during the month of February. Okay? Black History Month should be celebrated, or studying Black history should be celebrated all year long. So we're very excited to share what's been going on in the classrooms all month. And we put together a video with boys and girls from kindergarten through fifth grade reading their projects or telling you about what they did this month. There were many, many wonderful projects and ideas and displays that were outside of the classrooms. Many wonderful books that were read about many famous Black Americans. This is just a small showcase of what we learned. We would have liked to videotape many students, but for our program, we selected one student from every grade level, and that was really hard to do. In some classes, we even had to have a drawing because we had such a hard time trying to pick one student. But really, this is representative of all the things that have been going on in every grade level all month long. So I'm going to go ahead and show you the slideshow we put together.
Hi, my name is Olivia. I know about Wilma Rudolph. She couldn't walk in. Then she couldn't go to school. Then she took her brace off. And then she ran. And then she won her first gold medal.
Hi, my name is Sam Woolley, and I am in first grade. During Black History Month, I learned about Rosa Parks. Rosa Parks, she was a brave lady. She did not give up her seat. Rosa Parks was taken to jail. This helped start a boycott and change an unfair law.
Hi, my name is Malia Ajanuma. I am a second grader in Miss Arena's class. This is what I learned about Rosa Parks. When Rosa Parks was brave. Rosa Parks was brave. Rosa Parks said no, she would not stand up. She was brave going into the police car. She was brave when she was fingerprinted by the police. Rosa Parks went to jail. Rosa Parks was brave when she went to court. She was brave to boycott the bus. She was brave when she got back on the bus. Rosa Parks was brave when she lost her job. Rosa Parks was brave when she moved to Detroit.
Hello, my name is Sandy Jewel. third grade Ms. Plymouth's class, and I have studied Thurgood Marshall. Thurgood Marshall was born in July 2nd, 1908. He was the first African American Supreme Court justice. His most famous case was Brown versus Board of Education, which made it illegal to have segregated schools. As you can see, I made a cereal called Power Bites. I call it Power Bites because Thurgood Marshall was such a powerful man.
Hi, my name is D.L. Warren. I'm a fourth grader in Ms. Banks' class. During Black History Month, our class wrote a book called Sweet Clara and the Freedom Quote. After reading the book, we worked together to make our own class quote. What I learned was how the Freedom Quote was like a map that helped free others from slavery. Based on the story, Clara made a quote to save herself and others by memorizing what she saw when she escaped. She left the Freedom Quote behind so others could follow her path to freedom. The quote that I designed was very creative. It had lots of details and different 3D effects. Each student symbol was put together to make one class quote.
Hello, my name is Kristen Akridge, and I'm a student in Mr. Hannon's fifth grade class at Pepper Elementary School. This is an assignment about some of the things I learned during Black History Month. Mae Carroll Jemison is an American doctor and former astronaut for NASA. Mae Jemison was the first African-American woman to travel space. Jemison graduated at 16 from Morgan Park High in 1973. That same year, she enrolled at Stanford University on a National Achievement Scholarship. She pursued a double major in dance and theater. In 1977, she graduated with a B.S. in Chemical Engineering and a B.A. in African Afro-American Studies. Then from there, she went to the Cornell Medical College. When she was at Cornell, she studied Cuba and Kenya and also volunteered at a Cambodian refugee camp. In 1981, she received her Doctor of Medicine degree. After she got her degree in medicine, she interned at the LA County USC Medical Center. During her internship at USC, she practiced medicine. She became a part of NASA's space program in 1987. At this time, she was the first African-American woman accepted into the program. In 1992, Mae Jemison went to space. In space, she performed experiments, i.e. weightlessness, motion sickness, tadpoles, and zero gravity. In 1993, she resigned from NASA. In later years, Jemison started her own Institute for Technology. In 1999, she also started a medical device company. Down through the year, she has achievements on top of achievements. As a young Black lady in today's time, I'm just glad I have a positive role model like Mae Jemison to look up to. She has inspired me to follow my dreams. I know that the sky is the limit.
And I think Kristen sums it up best when she says that learning about Mae Jemison has inspired her, and knowing that the sky is the limit. That's what we want all of our students to believe, and we want all of our students to achieve. So thank you very much to those students, and their name is listed in the program for the parents to see. But I want to thank boys and girls, all of you, for doing something special to celebrate Black history, and the way that as a staff we decided to include everybody in this. Since only six people were able to read and share their essay or their project, was to do a slideshow of all the beautiful bulletin boards that you see around Pepper Elementary School. So we went around and took pictures of all of the beautiful bulletin boards, and we're going to show them to you now. as educators, it's so wonderful to see all of the excitement as children were yelling out, "That's my class, there's mine." So this was a way, again, that we could acknowledge and celebrate everyone's work during this month. So I hope you enjoyed the video and the slideshow presentation. Very briefly, I want to talk to students and parents about just a couple of things. Every year through Title I, we acknowledge reading and writing and math. You know, we had our family math event back in the fall. This is our celebration to honor writing. And also at the end of this month, on Wednesday, March 28th, we're going to have our annual Bingo for Books event to celebrate Reading Month as well. So we're always looking for ways to inspire students to strive to achieve their best in reading, writing, and math. And as we know, it takes a village, and we need the help of our parents as well. So whether you're reading to your children at home, or you're helping them with their writing, or you're making sure that they get on RAS Kids or IXL to practice their reading and math, we appreciate everything that you do. A few things that I just wanted to say about writing, since we are tying our writing into Black History Month, was that when we wrote the school improvement plan, we took a lot of feedback from parents as well as the teachers and all stakeholders, and we talked about the importance of being clear in your ideas. So for our younger kids, like kindergarten, first, and second, we want to make sure that their writing matches the picture that they drew and that the writing and the picture go hand in hand. As you see the kids go through the grades, though, the writing gets more complex, and we're focusing on clarity of the ideas. And you see the change from sentences to paragraphs with an introduction, three body paragraphs, and a conclusion. And the teachers talk to the kids about topic sentences and staying on topic. So writing is very important. The other area that we're focusing on is grammar and making sure not only that our kids are using proper grammar, but proper punctuation, capitals and periods, and trying to avoid those run-on sentences. So the last thing that we wrote about in our school improvement plan is building stamina. That means the ability to write for a longer period of time. So many times the kids write and then they're like, "I'm done." And we say, go back and look at your writing and see if there's anything else you can add to that writing to make it a stronger piece. So as we move forward, as teachers, we want all of our parents here to know that we are incorporating writing in all subject areas. We write in science. We write, as you can see, during our social studies. But we're also writing in math. We're also asking kids to write and explain. How did they solve that problem? Explain your thinking. In stories, we ask them to read two stories, and we say, how were those two stories similar? Or how were they different? And we ask them to write and explain. So just as important as reading and math are, writing is just right up there with them. So parents, on the back of your program for today is a list of all of the things that Title I and 31A have funded in our school. We are very fortunate at Pepper to have these additional funds to purchase things like RAS Kids or IXL, to bring in people like Miss Martinson, Miss Davis, Miss Ritter, who am I forgetting? Mrs. Clegg. And so we're very fortunate to bring in reading and math tutors during the school day so selected kids can go for a 30-minute reading or math intervention. We're fortunate to have Mr. Dedman and Mr. Terry as behavior support. We're fortunate to be able to get materials like math manipulatives, like books to give to our students, calculators, all of the extra things that we have in our classrooms are a direct result of our Title I and 31A budget. So I did a breakdown for you on the back so you can see how those funds are spent. And lastly, I just want to conclude with, as we leave March and as we leave February and we enter into March, we also start Reading Month. And again, Reading Month is just like Black History, it's just like writing, it's not one month. It's something that we do every single day, and we expect children to do over the summer months too. So our Reading Month theme this month is 2008 Reading Olympics. We tied it into the Winter Olympics that we just saw, and it's called Pepper Students Goal for Gold. So parents, as you're leaving today from the main hall, you're going to see a bunch of Team Gosshorn, Team Barachi, Team Blankenship, and all of those teachers' names are up there from kindergarten through fifth grade. And every Monday when your child gets a reading log, they're expected to turn it in either that Friday or the following Monday, and the teachers are going to be keeping count of how many students in their class turn in their reading logs. And we're going to have a little friendly competition. Kindergarten first and second, we're going to look at the highest percentage of reading logs turned in, and that class is going to win a pizza party. Third, fourth, and fifth grade, we're going to, you guys are going to be in a little friendly competition to see which class had the highest percentage, and one of those classes is going to win a pizza party. You guys are also going to get an extra gym period for the two winning classes, one from kindergarten through second, and one from third through fifth, okay? So we're very excited about what we do here at Pepper day in and day out. We have some of the most dedicated teachers that I've ever worked with. And boys and girls, if you can take a minute to give them a round of applause for everything they do. All right, moving on with our program, we are very excited to introduce the Pepper Elementary Choir, led by Mr. White. These students are extremely dedicated and they do all of their practices after school. So they have probably some of the most supportive parents that I see showing up for every performance to cheer their children on. So in just a moment, the choir will take the stage.
How's everybody doing? All right. So today, our choir, our faithful Pepper Choir, will be doing a few selections for you guys. We have what is called a Negro spiritual. We're doing one of those. We're doing some R&B. We're doing a little bit of everything, a little African song and different things like that. So without further ado, let's bring it on. All right, thank you. Thank you.
We'd like to introduce to you the Pepper Panthers Step Warriors.
All right, Step Warriors, it's showtime. Let's give him a round of applause. To our parents, please make sure you take the opportunity to tour the school. We have lots of writing displays. We have Black History Month projects hanging, literally hanging from the ceilings in the second and third grade hallway. We have fantastic essays and biographies in the front hallway. And we also have refreshments for our parents in room 110, which is right by the corner as you enter the building. Thank you for coming. And teachers, you may dismiss your students and have a wonderful day. And we will see you next year at the annual Literacy and Lyrics event.